What's up? I'm Yoni Schlesinger, and this is tutorial for Careless Whisper by George Michael. So you asked me for this tutorial, so how can I say no to this? Okay, so let's just go for it. As you all probably know already, if you try to play this song, it's only four chords. All the song is a repetitive four chords. It's D minor, G minor 7, B flat major 7. I'm doing B flat because sometimes I have to do things and I can do the major 7, but it's supposed to be B flat major 7 all the time. And A minor 7. And maybe the D minor is also 7, but D minor 7 is not much difference. Anyway, so this is the chords. But let's speak about the rhythm, okay? So if you probably saw my previous tutorials, was talking about that I'm not feeling as like a guitar player. I'm a drummer that can also produce music from his guitar. So let's just try to play the song, but without the music, just to feel the rhythm, okay? Okay, so what's going on here? If you're a drummer, you might want to do it like this. Okay, so what's the most important thing about to be the drummer in this case is to always be the snare, like, and never mind what you do in the middle, like you can do. You see, because it's all about the touch the snare, and while you touch the snare, do the snare, you can do also the ghost notes, like. Okay, so this is one thing, but I'm doing just you can try to practice just on the chords without I'm going to teach you of course of this, but let's just try to do the chords on this. Like, and when you start it, you do like tutum tutum, and you don't do that because you need to like put the drum inside, so you know. Yeah. Do the chords. This one or this one. And the snare, the sound of the snare, it's like chuck. I'm like with the pick, of course. Just taking the strings and with this part of the hand, just shut them off. So. And you don't have to be like a dramatic, too much dramatic, like. Just continue, like think. The drummers don't do. So we also won't do it, you do. A lot of like chicken, chicken. One time it's a snare. This is the practice. When you swim in with this, you can. It doesn't in the song this tuck tuck tuck, but it's like a practice just to feel free inside this pattern. Okay? So it's also about dynamics. Like if you in the chorus, it's like in this dynamic, and when you're in the verse, it becomes. Because in the verse you also do the guitar part. The guitar part is like. The... add this to the snare. Okay, so this is about the rhythm. I can't really go farther because it's something that you need to feel and practice a lot. It's not, I can't tell you just do this and do this. It just won't work. You just have to get the concept and just try to flow with it. And maybe play with the song like I started now. It's when you play with the song, you feel it much better. You feel the BPM of the song. And just try it. I really recommend playing with the song. Well, not just learn the song from tabs or chords and play it. Just I'm not even talking about just hear the chords. I tell you, even if you just read or get a tutorial like this, after you finish with me, go to the real George and try to do it with him, and then you'll be obligated to the rhythm and the BPM of the song and the dynamic. But okay, let's continue with what's going on the left hand. So we start with, this is what we're talking about, and then with the D minor, instead of this, we go into this shape, but we don't need all this shape of the bar, we just use this one finger, first finger, to press the 10th fret of the 3rd, 2nd and 1st string. So, you know, I probably got in this chord once, and then you just add the 9, which is the 12th fret of the first string. Okay, I do it with the little pinky, but you can do also with the 3rd finger, whatever you want. I like to work with this because it's gonna work hard in this song. So you just go with 4, 3, 2, and the 9th, and this one, and you pull it off, and just go back on on the D minor, like. Again. Okay, this is the first one. And then the G minor 7, we take it here on the, you know, like an A minor 7 on the 10th fret bar. And we add again this little pinky to it on the second string on the 13th fret. And again, it's like this one that you pull off and go on the chord. It's the same here. You start with this finger here, and then you pull it off and go back in the regular chord that we started all the way, like the G minor 7. Like. But here it's like until a 2nd string. You don't, here it was a 4, 3, 2, 1 string, and 1, 2, 3, 4. And here it's 5, 4, 3, 2, and you go back to 2, 3, 4. Okay, so. Yeah, and here, after you do second time of this, first time and second time, you don't go this again, because you need there is a bass progression, like. This is what the bass do. So we also add this A in this when we're on G minor 7. It's this finger that was on the 4th string. When we land on the way back on the 3rd string, this finger will go up to the 5th string to do this bass progression on A. So it will sound like this. Beautiful, huh? Such a beautiful song. Okay. And then we have to do like B flat minor 7, but I go to the regular B flat because I need to. I can also, but I don't care. I like the B flat. So regular B flat on a, you know, 6th fret bar. But the only difference you go all the way from 6, 5, 4, 5, 2, 1, like, okay, so, and ta, you get it with, again, this little pinky. You go to the 10th fret on the 2nd string. And you take it back. You don't need it anymore, so back to the regular chord. You back to the 2nd string, 3rd string, 4th string. Okay? And we go to A minor. It's supposed to be A minor 7, but ta da 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 da. So it starts with A minor because this is ta. So ta, we just do like power chord, like 6, 5, 4. See, and you landed on the 4th string here, inside the A minor, and the progression is ta da 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 da. So take this little pinky again. This little pinky walks hung in this song, but it's good that you walk it out a little bit. Just one fret up. Okay. This is the 3rd string, 5th fret, which is already here on the bow. So on the 3rd string, 7th fret. 2nd string, 5th fret, which is on the bar again. 6th fret on the 2nd string. 8th fret on the 2nd string. And 5th fret on the 1st string, which is on the bar. So. And I always add this. Now I add this, but when there is a rhythm, it's like. Yeah. This is something you need to work like. Because now it's also strumming, also the snare, and also this one. And this is something I can't teach, you just have to practice and try to make a sound during you do the snare feel. But you know it's there, so it's the first step for it. So let's see how it sounds till now. Talking about the drum section, the rhythm section, it's like you also do it, have to do a transaction like a drummer, like da 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 da. So I either do, but this is something you have to like combine this transaction with the what's going on the melody and the harmony. So it's not that easy. I do it naturally now because I do it for many years and I don't even have to think about it, but I can understand it's not coming so easily, but just to let you know what's going on though. Okay, so you do this 2 times, this intro, and you start the song, and when you start the song you do the regular chords, like in the regular shapes. This one, D minor 7, G minor 7, B flat, major 7 and A minor 7. So I feel so a lot of I go up like a note because there's something cheeky about going up, but the snare always go down, but not a hard snare, like a cool delicate snare. In the G minor 7, I also add this pinky here. Da, da, da. And bass, again. Like we did here. But now, we go from here, so. I feel so unsure as I take your hand. I do B flat major 7 this way. It's like do a D minor. But instead of this bar here, you take this finger to 6th string and 6th fret. So without the 6th string, because it's not participating here. But because you go like strumming and you can miss the 5th string, this finger that do the 6th string note will also You see, it doesn't let the fifth string go like this. She's blocking it, so. You see, it's a ghost note. And I don't touch the F. I can touch it, but it's make it another chord, so I don't touch the first string, so. As I take your hand. Ah, I also block it. This finger do a lot. She also block this, and she also block this, and then you have this, and you can go free, because it doesn't matter if you touch this or this. It's very important in a lot of chords that I always watch this in C chord. When people play C chord during a song, that they're strumming like free strumming, they do like this, and then you hear this. Not nice, because you don't want this E with the C. This is why when I play, I do C in the free, I do C like this. And then, and not, it's like a filth there. You don't need it all the time. So this was just a tip for C chord if you want to strum it, like add this finger on the G. So, where were we? At the verse. So, I feel so unsure as I take your hand and lead you to A minor 7, like this. Like A minor, just without the speaking. You that dance for as the music just goes to my again, the same. And just the dynamic of the strumming is a little bit more on the chorus. Like this, and after the first chorus, should have done better than the first chance that I've been given. So I'm gonna dance again the way I dance with you. You go to this one, like the verse, because the second time, after the second chorus, you go, when I dance with you, you go like the intro. So powerful on the next time when you go after the chorus, it's very powerful this again. Okay, so everything is the same. Let me think if there's something else I should talk about here. Tonight the music seems it's like the chorus, the dynamic of the chorus. Just at the end, but and the only difference is when you after this whole less falsetto and you get to this part, and you get to the A minor, do this is the what the guitar does. It's like, but let's do it on the A, because we're doing in we're just one guitar, we can't stop everything, so. But you can stop, actually. I do it on here. It's like 5-8-5 on the first string, 6-8-6 on the second string, 5-7-5 on the first string, 5-7-5 on the first string. So. This is about it. I hope it helped you, and I like to hear your comments. And if you want some more tutorials, I'm gonna do tutorials for many of the songs I uploaded recently, like Losing My Religion and Yellow and Kiss from Rose and California Dreaming, which you have also the chords in the description. So, and I have many new songs to upload soon. I won't tell you what, surprise. So that's it. Have a great Sunday, and see you soon. Bye bye.